My name is Sean Corcoran, and I'm the curator of prints and photographs here at the Museum of the City of New York and the curator of this exhibition. This exhibition is the result of a donation by a painter slash graffiti collector named Martin Wong in 1994. He, throughout the 80s, collected the material that you see on view here. It's been at the museum now for approximately 20 years, and over the last 5 or 6 years I've spent time researching the collection and meeting many of the artists and working towards producing a catalog and this exhibition, which just opened a few months ago. Particularly in the late 80s, when the bottom of the market fell out of graffiti art in the gallery world, Martin kind of redoubled his efforts at collecting and believed in the work so much he spent more and more money on it in the kind of belief that he could help shore up, you know, the ability of these artists to keep working. He actually went so far as to open a Museum of American Graffiti in 1989. It was very short-lived, but the fact that he was willing to invest so much into opening what he was hoping would be a long-term museum dedicated to the genre kind of speaks to his commitment to it. The difference really with him and a lot of collectors is that he did have a close relationship with them. It wasn't purely about buying the work of these young artists. It was about developing a relationship with them, being friends with them, going to dinner with them, hanging out with them, and talking about painting and encouraging them to feel like that they could be successful artists. I guess the image behind me is a good example. This is a painting by Lee Quiñones called, it's of a handball court that was done on the Lower East Side in 1978 of obviously Howard the Duck. But I think it exemplifies the collection and the work because, one, it represents kind of, it is a recreation of a historic handball court that existed in New York City for, you know, well over a decade. Two, it represents the relationship between the artist and the collector. Lee Quiñones was a very good friend of Martin Wong, and in fact, Lee lived with Martin for about a year or so, and they had a very close relationship. They talked about painting a lot, and they mutually influenced each other. So, in that sense, it works on two levels. It very much is about street art on the streets of New York City and about the collector-artist relationship. The editing and kind of selection for the exhibition, because there are about 150 pieces here, and the collection is comprised of more than 300 works and about another 60 black books, was a process of including work by key individuals from the time periods covered, 70s and 80s, including the kind of the more seminal work that Martin happened to own, and work that fit together in terms of relationships amongst artists. But I think that without the work of the 70s and 80s, the work of Banksy and all of the others wouldn't be possible. So again, it's my hope that it will inspire people to go back and find out about what came before.